Who's ready for another ScrawlrBox edition of No Box Art Box? Hello and welcome back to Jenna Gets Creative. It's time for another No Box Art Box challenge, and as promised in Tuesday's video, today I'm recreating the July 2020 ScrawlrBox as I wait for the real one to arrive. If you're not familiar with the No Box Art Box challenge, let's do a quick rundown. Step 1. Pick any art or craft subscription box, pick a past month's box you'd like to replicate, and look up the contents. Step 2. Match the contents as close as possible using items you already own. Exact matches are fine as long as you aren't replicating a box you actually received, and that box is the only reason you have that item. If that's the case, pick the next closest thing in your collection instead. Step 3. Make art. Use only the items you've matched in the box, and if the original box had a prompt or theme, try to stick to it. Only add missing essentials such as paper or a pencil. Have fun and share your art wherever you post using the hashtag NoBoxArtBox, all one word. Feel free to tag me to make sure I see it, because I do curate a master playlist of the challenge right here on YouTube. As usual, with my ArtBox videos, I'm going to talk about the supplies I'm using, and I'll put clips from the faux unboxing sequence back up in the corner of the screen as I start talking about each item, so you know exactly what I'm referring to. I'll have the original box's contents with the RRP in Great British Pounds, US Dollars, and Canadian Dollars in the description box down below, along with Amazon product listings if I could find them, so you can grab what you're interested in. Those are affiliate links, which means I earn a small percentage if you shop, totally optional. The links below are .com links, but if you need the .ca or .co.uk, I'll add my Master Supplies links page in the description as well. The description box will also include my best prices in the wild research, so we can tally up the RRP total for the box, the real world shopping total, and see the difference. I'll then break down the subscription price versus the different box totals, so you can see if the actual ScrawlrBox subscription would be worth it for you. I do have an affiliate link with ScrawlrBox that earns both of us £3 worth of loyalty points if you decide to sign up or order a past box. Two more quick announcements before we get on with talking about the supplies and the theme I'm working on. First, my website domain has changed to westvalepublishing.com. All links in this video and on my channel page are up to date, but I have hundreds of videos in my catalog, so just be aware that not all of the older links are accurate. If you previously signed up for email updates from my blog, you might need to do that again now that it moved. Second, thank you so much to everyone who has helped me hit 1k subscribers. That's requirement 1 of 2 to qualify for the YouTube Partner Program, and once I qualify, I will be hosting a big international giveaway of art supplies and custom artwork. It'll be open to subscribers age 14 plus, able to receive a package from Canada, and able and willing to provide your mailing address if you win. The other requirement I need to meet is 4,000 total watch hours from the last 12 months, and we're sitting at around 3,000 right now, so every minute you leave this video playing helps. Those who watch in faster speeds, please be conscious that YouTube does count that as half watch time. Also, just curious, how do you visually process speed paints played at higher speeds when I've already sped up the footage? I couldn't do it. Bravo if you can track that. Okay. Moving on. The theme for the July 2020 ScrawlrBox that I'll be sticking to is Mother Nature, so I think it's time for a nice, relaxed scenery piece. One thing I've started to notice doing so many of these box challenges with a single paintbrush is that I'm getting really tired of being restricted to just one brush. But thankfully, a flat brush can be used on the edge for a drastically different line, so there's that. I argue flat brushes are much more versatile than round brushes. Maybe that's just me. Let me know if you disagree in the comments down below. The first item on the actual box contents list is 3 15mm tubes of Derivan liquid pencil in grey 9, yellow, and blue. This is water-soluble graphite in a paste, and I was able to find the full 12-color set in this size on Amazon, so that product listing is down below if you're interested. I was able to read the prices on the first side of the menu card in some people's Instagram unboxing photos, so we're going with the ScrawlrBox's claim that these have an RRP of £3.95 each, but if you go on Derivan's website and convert their price from Australian dollars to Great British Pounds, it's actually a little higher right now. I'm also finding it's very difficult to find the 15mm tubes open stock, but plenty of art stores carry the larger 40mm jars, so if this ends up being a product you love, Jackson's in particular, which is my go-to for getting UK prices in the wild, only stocks the 40mm size. I read this as Derwent first, so thank goodness Jackson's site brought up the Derivan products when I searched Derwent liquid pencil, or I wouldn't have caught the error. Originally, I thought this would be one of those rare boxes I couldn't possibly replicate for NoBox ArtBox because I don't have graphite paint like this, but then I realized I do have tinted water-soluble graphite. I have a few Derwent Graphy Tint pencils, so that's what I'm using. The best I can do for matching the colors, since I only have 8 Graphy Tint pencils, is Midnight Black in place of Gray 9, Ivy in place of yellow, and Shadow in place of the blue. I'll be using these with the brush, not directly on the page like a pencil, so I do have the freedom to really dilute it. I can definitely get gray tones out of that black pencil. The Derivan yellow is quite earthy and cool toned, so the light green Ivy shade is actually quite close, and Shadow is a mid-toned blue. The second item on the menu card is a pair of Derwent water-soluble graphite sketching pencils. The box sent a medium wash 4B and dark wash 8B. I happen to own these exact pencils from purchasing the 6 tin ages ago, so that's what I'll be using. Next up is a ScrawlrBox branded number 10 flat brush with synthetic bristles. I'm guessing this will be similar to the number 10 flat brush they sent us in July 2019 box, exactly 1 year ago, so that's the brush I'll be using. But if I didn't have that, I would have probably grabbed my quarter inch flat black and gold wash brush from Dynasty. It's pretty much the same size as a basic number 10 flat, and I love it so much. Keep in mind for pricing this box, I've assumed that the ScrawlrBox brush will be the same price as last year's brush in the same size, so I'm reporting £2.50. Since we're working in graphite, it makes perfect sense that we need an eraser. The actual box has provided a blue and white combined eraser by Koh-i-Noor, but I can't find that listed anywhere, so I've estimated the RRP based on the pink and blue combined eraser listing on Jackson's. In its place, I'm using a blue and white combined eraser from a geometry set. Finally, the paper. The July box sent an 8-sheet A5 pad of Aquarelle Etival watercolor paper by Claire Fontaine. This is 300 GSM cold press paper, so I'll be using the cold press paper the June box sent in its place. The Sea White of Brighton 350 GSM cold press paper in pre-cut A5 size sheets. I decided to paint a forest valley loosely based on the first reference photo with visible sky that came up when I searched Pixabay for the term forest. This was a lot of fun, but I think working in inks and ink tints recently has spoiled me because I wasn't expecting the layers of graphite to reactivate as much as they did. I'm also wondering whether or not the real liquid pencil is going to lay down grainy or not, since my washes made with the water-soluble graphite pencils was a bit grainy on the page. As you may have noticed in my swatching at the beginning, this stuff does not erase. Including an eraser is pretty pointless, it just smudges it. If you were watching really closely, you'll have seen that I tested with my Tombow Mono too, so it wasn't just the crappy geometry set eraser I matched for the box. I like how this turned out overall, and I like this combination of colors, but I'm wondering if any of the filter options when I post this to Instagram will make it look more like I used a yellow instead of a green without washing the piece out entirely. Now that they print a selection of participant photos in the zine, I really want this to look legit because by the time I get the real box and post about it, I'm sure the next zine will already be printed. The August box will probably already be shipped. Canadian problems, right? Next week, I'll be doing the Colors of the Month challenge combination for August, and then we'll hold round 3 of the TSS Character Symbols Tournament. This month's challenge colors are pale pink, canary yellow, and royal blue. What should I paint with those? Remember, I'll be using my Caron Brushmarker Pro watercolor markers. Should I do another colorful animal, or should I embrace the very floral palette and do some flowers? If you're looking for more to watch, I've got some suggestions up on the left side of the screen now, or if you'd like to check out my bookish channel, the Westville Archives, you can click my face on the right. I upload art content here twice a week at minimum, every Tuesday and Thursday, and if you like living life creatively, whatever that means to you, I'd love to have you along for the ride. Bye guys!